How the space tourism industry is stuck in a billionaire phase. Hello and welcome back to Front Seat Finance. The spectacle of launching billionaires into space is the beginning of a long road ahead. But what about normal people who can't afford the billions of dollars to fly to space and back? Let's find out in today's video. Sir Richard Branson's extravagant jaunt to space last month was the dawning of a new space age for the few people that can afford it. Jeff Bezos, the richest man on the planet, was the next to launch himself to space with three others on his company, Blue Origin's first crewed flight. The two billionaires are validating their company's tourist-tailored rockets, and they say, fulfilling lifelong dreams to get a brief taste of space. But what Virgin Galactic and Blue Origin's mission show is that space is almost open, not for you and me or the general public, but for more billionaires. Opening up the cosmos to the masses and normalizing space travel is a goal companies and their billionaire backers have been targeting for years but haven't yet achieved. There's economic potential beyond launching rich people to space. Microgravity research for scientists and a much farther goal, rapid transportation between continents. That's the vision they're selling with these flashy flights. Once exclusive to government astronauts, traveling in space could be a thing for everyone else too. That's the dream, right? That space isn't just for NASA anymore. Kathy Luters, NASA's human spaceflight chief who oversaw development of SpaceX's Crew Dragon astronaut capsule, said during a press conference in April. I think that's what we're trying to do. What we were hoping is that you would hopefully have so many customers that at one point, the price point would go down to having it be accessible. It's tough at the beginning. The scene right now. In this beginning phase, flying to space is priced only for the ultra-rich, driven by the high costs of new space technology. Virgin Galactic's launch of Richard Branson represented one of the final key test missions to validate its shiny six-seated space plane, Spaceship Two, but it was also a meticulously crafted marketing event, complete with flashy promo videos, inspirational speeches, and a pop concert, all designed to help attract more attention and more customers. To live their own version of Branson's dream, customers will have to pay at least $250,000 for a seat. And right now, the $250,000 price tag is the cheapest option on the market. The price for a seat on Blue Origin's New Shepard rocket could be higher. And if you want to go into orbit for a few days, a ride on SpaceX's Crew Dragon capsule will set you back at least $55 million. Unanswered questions. While Branson and Bezos' flights to space mark key moments for their space tourism businesses, the space industry is far from being able to offer its services to the rest of the public. To get there, they'll have to clear several hurdles. Can these rockets reliably fly humans on multiple missions without a hitch? If there is a hitch, like a fatal accident, can the market survive a damaged reputation? And can someone buy a ticket to space just as they can book an expensive flight instead of just the ultra-rich? Then there's the court of public opinion, which may be difficult to win over. Bezos, Branson, and Elon Musk's space ambitions have been criticized as another example of billionaires spending money on passion projects when there are places and causes where those funds could arguably be put to better use. The US alone struggles with vast wealth inequities, poor access to healthcare, and a rapidly changing climate, among other problems that, when paired with space tourism, makes the activity look insultingly selfish to many. Senator Bernie Sanders, IDT, a leading critic of billionaires, has repeated that point as the private space race heats up. Here on Earth, in the richest country on the planet, half our people live paycheck to paycheck. People are struggling to feed themselves, struggling to see a doctor. But hey, the richest guys in the world are off in outer space. He tweeted in March. I can understand it, Branson says of critiques like Sen Sanders, speaking on The Late Show with Stephen Colbert on July 14th. But I think maybe they're not fully educated as to what space does for Earth. Branson, like other space advocates, point to the technologies that investments in space have helped propel into the mainstream, like the GPS capabilities wired into smartphones, weather tracking services or climate change research, and modeling from satellites in low Earth orbit. Many of those investments came from public funds. It's still unclear what spin-off developments might emerge from the still-fledgling private space tourism industry. And while space flight and space tourism is just beginning to open up to the common man, the richest billionaires and millionaires are already making it a luxury industry. Currently, you either have to be talented, handpicked by a billionaire, or lucky to book a ride on one of these rockets without paying the steep price tag. However, there is hope for people like you and me. Raffling off tickets, like Virgin Galactic plans to do, and donating seats to space enthusiasts who can't afford them keeps the public dream of normalized, low-cost space travel alive while the industry races to find the right recipe for bringing prices down. With that, we wrap up today's video. Hope you enjoyed our insight on the future of space travel for normal individuals. Thanks for watching.